eggs. This activity will help your little one practice rhyming. Rhyming is an important phonological awareness skill so that reading will come easily. Sometimes we use real words when rhyming, and sometimes we use nonsense words to rhyme. We will use both real words and nonsense words for our activity. Our at words for today will be rat, hat, tat, and bat. Our ug words are rug, hug, tug, and bug. Our ot words are rot, hot, tot, and bot. And our ip words are rip, hip, tip, and bip. Today, you will need a plastic Easter egg and a Sharpie marker. On the small part of the egg, you will write the initial sound. And on the larger part of the egg, you will write the rhyme. Our first word is rot. Then, bat. Next, you will write hip. And finally, you will write tug. You may introduce your child to the rhyme, such as ot. Then slowly turn the egg to make different rhymes. Here we show the ip words. All right, Laura, look. I have two letters, and when we say each sound, it goes at. Can you say at? Say at. Uh-huh, at. And then we go b, at. What's that word? Mm-hmm. Yes, bat. And then we're going to turn our egg, and we have at.
What?
Yes, rat. And then we have to turn our egg and we have at.
Hat.
Very good reading.
Next, we have initial sound eggs. There are two options for this activity. Option one, cut out each egg and cut in half on the zigzag line. Mix up the pieces and allow children to match the correct letter to the initial sound like a puzzle. Here is option one, a picture on top and the initial sound to be matched on the bottom. Option two, if you do not have time to cut out 26 eggs, use the second copy of the printable. Allow your child to cut on the lines to practice cutting skills while strengthening hand and finger muscles. Mix up the eggs so that they are not in order. Ask your child to pick an egg and write the letter of the initial sound in the bottom portion of the egg. This also works on handwriting skills. Here's an example of option two. Your child will decide the initial sound for each picture and write it in the bottom portion of the egg. First, have your child carefully cut on the lines to cut apart all of the eggs. We decided to use stamps instead of handwriting. Have your child say the name of the picture and then find the initial sound to match the picture.